A saying goes, nothing lasts forever. Although the diamond industry would like you to think otherwise, and I believe the Wu-Tang Clan also makes the forever claim. Home batteries, however, don't fall into that category, and their lifespan is measured in discharge cycles. Hi, hello there. I'm Sinue with Drone Quote. And in today's video, we will talk about battery discharge cycles and what that means for you if you're considering a battery for your home. This is the third and final video in our three-part series geared to help you understand batteries to have the right expectations if you plan to install a battery for your home. The previous video explained the critical difference between peak and continuous power output, and you can watch it by clicking above. Now let's get started. A battery discharge cycle refers to the process of discharging the battery from its fully charged state to its fully discharged state, and then recharging back to its full capacity. Understanding discharge cycles is essential because it directly impacts a battery's lifespan and warranty terms. Let's delve into those details. Batteries have limited discharge cycles they can undergo before the capacity degrades significantly. A cycle is counted as one complete discharge and recharge of the battery. Each time a battery goes through a discharge cycle, its internal chemical reactions cause gradual wear and tear, reducing its overall capacity over time. Shallower discharge cycles, like discharging the battery by 20% rather than 80%, are less stressful on the battery and tend to extend its lifespan. This is because the battery experiences less wear during each cycle, resulting in slower capacity degradation. Battery chemistry and quality significantly determine how many discharge cycles a battery can endure before reaching the end of its useful life. The depth of discharge, DOD, is closely related to discharge cycles. It refers to the proportion of the battery's total capacity discharged during a cycle. Generally, batteries with a lower depth of discharge per cycle tend to have longer lifespans. For instance, a battery discharged to 20% DOD during each cycle will typically last longer than one discharged to 80% DOD per cycle. Battery manufacturers often specify warranties based on their number of discharge cycles or years of use, whichever comes first. For example, a battery may come with a warranty of 10 years or 5,000 cycles, whichever is reached earlier. If the battery undergoes more cycles than specified in the warranty, its capacity might degrade beyond a certain point, reducing its ability to hold the charge effectively. Deep discharge cycles can lead to faster capacity degradation, potentially impacting the battery's performance and voiding the warranty if the specified cycle limit is exceeded. Given that some batteries allow you to change the depth of discharge, it is critical to follow the manufacturer's recommendations, as this will directly correlate to the warranty. Avoid excessive deep discharges whenever possible, as they can accelerate capacity degradation. Also, ensure the battery is not subjected to extreme temperatures impacting its lifespan. That's why it's a good idea to install a battery out of direct sunlight if possible. Regularly monitor the battery's performance and capacity to identify potential issues early on. I know I sound like a broken record since I stressed the importance of monitoring your solar panels in several other videos, but you're only helping yourself. Understanding battery discharge cycles and their impact on lifespan and warranties helps users make informed decisions about battery usage, maintenance, and replacement, leading to a more cost-effective and reliable energy storage system. And if you're considering a battery for your home, click on the screen here where I discuss if a battery is even worth it. Should you like this video and would like to show us some support, please click the subscribe button if you want. And until next time, hasta la vista, baby.